you very much. Klaus, come here. Come here. Make a wish.
Sure.
Why not?
Thanks.
Happy birthday to you. Hey, dear Klaus, happy birthday to you. Sing along.
Killarna i rockbandet R.E.M. träffades 1980 och har sedan dess sakta men säkert etablerat sig som ett av världens största band. De är här ikväll, de står i kulisserna, de vill spela för er, men innan dess ska vi ta ett litet samtal med dem. Hälsa välkomna nu Mike Mills, Peter Buck och Michael Stipe! We've never had this many guests at the same time.
I'll leave, so it's
okay. No, I want you here. I want you here. Welcome to Sweden, the homeland of the Muppet, or the chef from the Muppets.
The Swedish chef,
right.
That's great.
I hear you guys are big fans of the Muppets.
Ever since we were children.
Is that true?
Yeah.
You've even been on the Muppet Show, I've heard.
That's right.
What was that all about?
Well, it's about believing that a little ball of fur with some guy's hand inside it is a real person.
Okay.
And that's
you have to start believing that. Yeah. What did you do on the show?
We took a song, an old song of ours, and changed the words to fit the world of Muppets. And Shiny Happy People turned into
Furry Happy Monsters.
Furry Happy Monsters.
Furry Happy.
And we all got to dance.
Okay. If somebody would have said like 5 or 10 years ago to me that R.E.M. were on the Muppet Show, I wouldn't have believed it. Why are you doing it now?
Why wouldn't you have believed it?
No, because you were so serious. I mean, the serious R.E.M., you know.
Do you think a serious person would wear this shirt?
No. Well, you know, we've seen you in the videos where everybody hurts and everything is very, you know, depressive. And then also,
it's a very somber song. I mean, you wouldn't want to be dancing around with puppets for a song like Everybody Hurts. But, you know, like most people, we're kind of multifaceted, and I think our music is too.
But would you have done it 5 years ago?
Probably not, actually. But, you know, I think we're having more fun doing this than we have been in the past, in that I think our sense of personal dignity has just gone straight down the toilet. So we can do whatever we feel like.
No, but because I have a theory. I think it works vice versa. I think you're doing yourself a favor by being on the Muppets, because then you're, I mean, if you're already stereotyped as one sort of a group, then we think, whoa, these guys are cool. They can do this as well.
Well, it was a great experience because we weren't taken very seriously. I mean, we were made fun of by little hand puppets. And it's kind of nice to remind yourself that, you know, that's your lot in life. You know, this is kind of silly, and why not embrace it?
Yeah, good. One of your songs, Man on the Moon, is going to be the title of the next Jim Carrey movie.
Yeah, Milos Forman film,
right?
Starring Jim Carrey, and it's about the life of Andy Kaufman,
right?
Who's a comic, a stand-up comic from the U.S., who was a big influence on me and on all of us.
In Sweden, he's known in the sitcom Taxi.
Taxi.
He plays Latka.
Yeah. That was probably his most popular. That's how most people know him.
Okay.
And he was like Lenny Bruce. He was a brilliant stand-up comedian who was a decade and a half ahead of his time in terms of the stuff that he was kind of covering, the stuff that he was dealing with.
All right. And he died too early as well.
He died of cancer. Yeah. Yeah. And we wrote the song "Man on the Moon" in '92. Is that right?
For him.
It was about him. Yeah.
Okay.
Kind of. He inspired it greatly and did the video with footage of him jumping around pretending like he was Elvis Presley.
Okay.
And that inspired. That inspired a TV show and now the script.
All right. So, but there is no more involvement for you guys in that movie.
We're hoping to score it. Milos really wants us to, and everyone wants us to.
All right.
The lawyers are kind of hashing it out still.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I hear that Peter, you're very, you're sort of a record collector. Is that true? How many records do you own?
I would hate to say it's something like 25,000.
25,000 records? That's a lot of records. Where do you store them?
Every single available space in my house is covered with records or children's toys. So there's nowhere to sit, nowhere to stand. We don't have a dining room. You know, we kind of eat sitting on the floor, but we have a lot of
Is it alphabetized in any way? Or no, just...
Yeah, I would like to, you know, at one day I will spend a year or two doing that, but no, they're just piled up all over the place.
What's the latest record you bought that you really went, oh, wow, this is just as good as Gang of Four?
At the airport in London on the way over here, I bought a group called the Beta Band.
Beta Band?
Yeah, they're really good. We you know, I buy records all the time. My bag's in the back room. I've got like 50 CDs in it.
Oh, right, yeah, now. I saw the bag.
It's very heavy.
Do you guys get to borrow his records?
If he didn't live 3,000 miles away, we would.
Oh, but I mean like on tour now.
Yeah, if they're really good, he'll say, you got to listen to this. Right. We got, I got it, I guess when we were here in the fall, a CD by a Swedish band called Selfish.
Is that right?
It's really good.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a really good record.
Oh, good. Selfish. Lena Englund, I think it is. Mm-hmm. Singing all that. Do you know any other Swedish bands?
The Nomads.
Nomads. Yeah. I thought you would know the Nomads.
Yeah, they're great. They're one of the guys who's playing with us, Scott McCoy, has co-written songs with them.
Okay.
And I've really loved their records for a long time.
I just sound like a dork. Are there Cardigans from here?
Yeah, okay. That's true.
The Pushkins.
Yeah, they're good.
The Pushkins?
Yeah, the Pushkins.
You call them that?
Yeah.
Why? What does that mean?
No, there's a band called the Pushkins.
No, there's a band.
Oh, I've never heard of
it. Is it Pushkins? I think it's the Pushkins, yeah.
Pushkins,
yeah. Not from Sweden.
Yes. Yep. See?
I'm pretty much into music myself. I don't have 25.
I've got the CD.
But I don't have the Pushkins. Do you have the Pushkins?
We have it back there.
Could we get an assistant to get the Pushkins album, please, right now? So we'll just take a look at it. We can keep talking.
It's in the green room.
It's in the green room.
It's in my bag in the green room.
Okay. Mike Mills, you're the only one still living in Athens, Georgia.
More. No, there are probably 50,000 people still living.
But in the band. In the band. And I heard you're involved in local politics.
Well, you know, I mean, as much fun as it is to talk about world politics, the real work that you can do is locally.
Yeah.
The most effect you can have is on the local level.
And what does that really mean? What do you do?
We try to support the candidates that think the same way we do.
Okay.
You know, historical preservation and not tearing down buildings to put up big ugly ones.
I've heard that you've even given money to the community.
Oh, yeah.
So that they can preserve buildings.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's an important thing when you get to this position and you have the wherewithal to help people out, whether it's through influence or through money. I think you should do the things you can.
Mm-hmm. I heard that you even were given like the keys to the city. Is that true?
I don't think so.
Yeah. That sounds very fancy. I don't know what that is.
Well, what does it do? It does,
is it a piece of
there's no lock, so the key.
Yeah, that was one. The second question.
We got the key to some city. What was it? We got the key to Catania.
We got the key to Macon.
Yeah. Not Catania. Catania.
Catania.
Sicily.
In Sicily. Yeah.
In Sicily, wow. Yeah. And what does that actually do?
It's a key, but you know, if you show it to people in a bar, they're really impressed.
Okay.
We went to Shreveport, Louisiana, and the mayor wouldn't let his daughter give us the key, so she gave us the keychain.
All right.
So we have that.
Here's the record, by the way. Let's see what that is. The Pushkins.
Thank you.
It's the EP, actually.
Oh,
we don't have the CD, it's just the EP.
It looks like more like Russian or something. Oh, Linköping, Sweden. All right. Meet here. The Pushkins. That's good. You're teaching us something. We're going to finish the interview with a little quiz about Sweden.
Oh, boy.
To see how much you know about Sweden. And just to assist me in that, you have to have these buttons that you press on when you know the answer. So please try. You have to press the button for a long time. Can we hear Peter Buck's sound? Okay, thank you. And how about Mike? That's great. All right. And this is very serious now, so I'll take out my pen as well. The first one to 3 points wins. Okay. All right, you guys ready?
Yep.
Name one of Ingmar Bergman's films.
Cries and Whispers?
Cries and Whispers.
Did I say that?
Is that what
it's called?
No. That's correct.
Okay, there, yeah, I did say
right,
okay.
That's great. Viskningar och rop in Swedish.
It is in English.
What is the second biggest city in Sweden? Mike?
Gothenburg.
Gothenburg, that's good.
Göteborg.
Can you stop? You're last. You're in last place right now.
Right.
You better get your act together. Here's a question for you, but you also can compete. Name a Swedish athlete. Who was that?
That was me.
Yeah?
I couldn't wait.
I didn't think you were going to get one.
Bjorn Borg.
Bjorn Borg, all right. Very good. Ingmar Johansson, that's true, that he's a boxer. Yeah. You guys are good. How about this one? Which famous Swedish hero helped the Jewish people in Hungary during World War II?
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
No. Zero. Zero.
Minus one.
That was a serious question.
I'm sorry.
That was Raoul Wallenberg. Mm. Have you heard of him?
Yes.
He was a big hero. Okay, last question. Which Swedish garage band released an album in the 80s called Outburst?
Oh, I don't know.
Come on, Peter.
Well, okay, I'll just say the Nomads.
All right, that is correct. We have a tie here, unfortunately. You have 2 points, and you have 2 points, and you have zero.
I'm in the negatives at this point.
We're going to have a Utslogs question, which means that one last question, the one of you who gets
the lightning round.
Okay, I'm going to show you a picture, and this is a very famous Swedish man, and you tell me who it is, all right? You ready? Here he is.
No idea.
Michael knows.
No, I do not know who that is.
Okay. He's all right.
Your brother.
No, it's not my brother. No, he's much older than I am. He's a sports commentator.
Oh. Did you guys know that, the audience?
Did everyone know that here?
Yes. See?
You did? Oh, they're just saying no to be nice to him. They're just saying. All right, we're going to finish this off. Let me see. This is a tie, sort of.
Yeah.
One last question. Sorry, we have to get a winner. Does Sweden have a king?
Yes.
All right, good. We have a winner. Mike Mills. Congratulations. Great. We're going to perform in a few minutes. Get back there and get ready. Thanks a lot for coming here. Good luck with playing. All right. This is R.E.M. Franz och Heiko. Mycket lämpligt idag med gitarrtema dessutom. Eftersom vi har ju gitarrer här bakom oss. De ska spela här för oss. Det här är R.E.M. At My Most Beautiful. albumet Up. All right. Beautiful song. Tack så mycket. Vi är tillbaka nästa vecka igen. Då blir det bra.
Yesterday, but.